Hey now, yeah, good morning, PSW staff, clients, and friends joining us for a Thursday, pretty much through the week, piece of cake. Tomorrow we get to see your film screen results for The Sandlot. You guys did a great job picking, something to replace the Ray Charles America the Beautiful, which is still one of the best American, best versions of that song. And yesterday we looked at the great vibraphonist, Lionel Hampton, and that amazing solo he took on Stardust. I hope that meant something to you, even if it's not your thing. Just give it a few minutes of your life and see what you think. Today, it's summer. The country's opening back up. We should get some sun, some fun in the sun, rather, and look at some, summer festivities, things that we could do. I haven't been to this place in a long time, but I grew up loving it. And I just think it's time to go back to the place that you love. John loves, Megan loves, Lloyd loves, Bonnie loves. It's going to be Lloyd-erific, Bonnie-erific, John-erific, Megan-erific for sure, because we're going to be looking at a very cool historical place that's still there. Today we're going to be looking at the Santa Monica Pier.
If everybody had an ocean across the USA, then everybody'd be surfing like California. You'd see them wearing their baggies, Warachi sandals too, a bushy, bushy blonde hairdo, serving USA. You'll catch them serving.
So they didn't build the pier for fun at first. They built it for sanitation needs, actually. So it was really just meant as a sewer, because this was 1909 the pier opens. It took 16 months to build. Opens in the public September 1909. But thousands of people flocked to the sea and came to the pier to enjoy festivities and bands playing and swimming races. There's something about the ocean and the sea that just puts a smile on people's faces, because it's just so, so great. The pier gets 8 million visitors a year now. So it's a huge destination. And so we're just gonna have a lot of fun looking at it. So here's our timeline. If it opens in 1909, This is when things are happening in the city. So we've looked at, this is a few years after Abbot Kinney and the Venice Canals happened in 1905. Because remember, if you remember, Abbot Kinney, did the Venice Canals and then the Venice Boardwalk and had a little amusement park, but that didn't really happen because Disneyland comes in the 50s. So Santa Monica had two piers in the beginning. It had more than that, but the current pier is made up of two adjoining piers. Let's just look at 1909 for a little bit. What's going on in the world? First fingerprint evidence in a murder case is used. So they solved a murder in 1909 using the world's first official fingerprint bureau. It was founded in Scotland Yard in 1901, but then they said that the world's first fingerprint was in Calcutta, India in 1897, but I guess this is the first time that they used it to solve a murder in 1909. I had no idea. What else happens? NAACP, actually, I didn't know that they joined, but they, because of all the lynching going on in the 1908 race riot in Illinois, all this violence happening, a group of white liberals got together and included, they got together for a meeting to discuss racial injustice and racial justice, and about 60 people, several of whom were blacks as well, W.E.D. Du Bois, and other people attended the meeting. They start the NAACP, which is still obviously thriving. What else happens? In New York, Queensboro Bridge opens. So, okay, we're opening our pier. I think that's just as cool as a bridge, but that's the 59th Street Bridge in New York. Music. 1909 is early. I mean, right now, Scott Joplin's playing, Maple Leaf Rag. Ragtime music's going on. But then also Mahler is still writing music. I mean, so there's these huge symphonic works being played. We're getting into Tin Pan Alley. We talked about that in New York, that the song factories were going on. Irving Berlin starts writing music. This is a little earlier than Gershwin's not writing yet in 1909, but the songwriting factory is starting to really take hold. So Dixieland music is coming in. We have yet to get to the swing era in the 20s, but so that's just a little bit of when the pier is being constructed. So it was quickly a fishing destination after it opened up. But after a few years, a carousel came in, and Charles Loof was very involved in this opportunity to capitalize on people coming out to the pier. He was somebody that had a dream that said we should have an adjoining second pier for amusement, and that amusement park should be built. One was to carry sewer pipes to beyond the breakers, and didn't have any amenities, but Charles Loof was just like, we're gonna need amenities. And he was very famous because he had built Coney Island's first carousel in Brooklyn, in New York. So he saw potential in Santa Monica being an attraction, and began constructing his own, they called it a pleasure pier in 1916. So in 1916, it's the Hippodrome opened, and this gave people a chance to ride the new carousel. And that was the first ride there. And that carousel became Santa Monica's first national historic landmark. And then the Philadelphia Toboggan Company, they built the carousel in 1922, and that had 44 hand-carved horses. A lot of these things aren't original. A lot of these things were rebuilt. Like in the 90s, the Hippodrome was rebuilt, and there's musical accompaniment by a Calliope. But it's probably good. They updated it and still kept it kind of looking classic. Then the La Monica Ballroom opened in 1924. That's not there anymore, but that was this beautiful Spanish facade and French Renaissance interior. And it had the largest dance hall on the West Coast. So people were dancing a lot over here. It could accommodate 5,000 dancers on this hard maple floor. And the famous country star Spade Cooley, he televised his weekly TV program. But it was the first time, because this was 1948, this is pretty early, it was the first time that a musical TV show ever was televised live. Because as we know, radio was prominent, but TV was starting to come in. And of course, when there's business, ventures and stuff like that, you're going to get mobsters, because mobsters are really, their goal is not to kill people. Their goal is for money, to make money. And if they happen to accidentally kill people, then that's, so of course they saw an opportunity. So this was for offshore gambling. We've talked about the mafia ships, and Tony Carnero was kind of the big mobster guy that set up these gambling ships, because they found kind of a loophole, because if you go 3 miles off the coast, that's in international waters, that's not, you can kind of do whatever you want out there. So it was, he would look at maps and make sure, okay, if we're right here at this distance, they can't arrest us. So that was kind of a loophole. Of course, they took that down, but for a long time, there was illegal gambling and all of these things going on. The last big one that he had was the Rex, which was added in 1939, came to be known as the Battle of Santa Monica Bay. And there was this big standoff between Carnero and the police and stuff. So that went away. But of course, there's always some mobster story. 1930s, we get something that you've heard of, Muscle Beach. Muscle Beach is very famous. It brought in another attraction kind of separate, close to the pier. But it's world famous. Muscle Beach, it had, that was the start of bodybuilding. We're kind of responsible, I guess it's good that we're responsible for the birth of bodybuilding with, Jack LaLanne and Joe Gold, who's Gold's Gym, of course. They worked out there, and they established the Santa Monica Muscle Beach as the location of the physical fitness boom. But throughout the 50s and 60s, the pier also was very satisfying to a lot of fishermen that would go out there, and tourists alike, just to walk around. They recommend that if you do fish today, do not eat the fish because of the high levels of mercury. So it's more of just like a hobby to do out there. 58 to 62, they had a ballroom with a roller skating rink, and this was the skaters' ballroom. in the 70s, you know, again, we always get to that depressing part of the class when disrepair comes in. And Santa Monica City Council ordered demolition of the piers. So they wanted to get rid of this. But actually, a group came together to fight for them to keep this. Thank God. They developed a Save Our Pier Forever campaign. I mean, so it was almost taken away from us. 1983, a winter storm really damaged the pier, which sounds kind of funny because we don't really have storms that much, but it destroyed about one third of the whole entire structure. So that was really scary. One thing that sticks out, of course, is that great Ferris wheel, right? You know, of course, it's not the same Ferris wheel that we, you know, that's been there all along, but in 2016, it celebrated its 20th birthday with $1 million renovation because it had all, you know, it's got all these beautiful lights. It's got 174,000 LED lights that, and, you know, have all these beautiful colors. I think it's really cool and really fun. Maybe it's kind of, I don't know, hokey, but I think it's really fun to look at. Santa Monica Pier also marks the end of, you know, you've all heard of Route 66 that was created in 1926 with a link, you know, from Chicago to Los Angeles, you know, the Route 66 route. So it ends there at the pier, just in case you were wondering if you wanted to drive through it. And today it's a large double jointed pier. There's two at the foot of Colorado Avenue in Santa Monica. And, you know, little amusement park there. There's bumper cars there. There's concession stands. And, you know, it's free except for the Ferris wheel. But, and you can do, you know, there's fishing, like I said. It's just really fun. It's a classic part. I just thought we'd have some fun in the sun. I know I said that twice, but it really is. It's such a lovely little attraction that deserves a little shout out since the weather's kind of heating up a little bit. So hope you enjoyed that. Can't wait to show you Sandlot tomorrow. It's going to be really, really fun. Miss you and love you. And I've said way too much already. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. Yeah, everybody's got surfing. Surfing USA.